the hardest part of this is remaining completely and utterly alone, isolated. It's been a long time now. When Thomas was alive, we stood together a little bit, just a little. But other than that, in my last 8 years, there have been people standing observing. There are people that on occasion share a pleasantry, bring a drink, make a token donation. But a U.S. soldier on duty in Afghanistan at a remote outpost I stretch it a bit and imagine that one is there on post by himself for weeks or longer. Maybe worse, as somehow is certain that he has been forgotten by the command, by the rest of the troops, totally isolated. Well, one could object, my goodness, there's a woman's auxiliary, there is the USO. Fine, the soldier is standing by himself for a long time. One of the impacts on me of that is to constantly reassess, is where I'm standing the right spot? Am I standing in the wrong spot? Is that why I'm alone? And the clarity so far is just crystal clear. No, I'm standing on the right spot, and no one else wants to stand there. That's why I'm alone. I'm not standing on the wrong spot. Other people are standing on the wrong spot or no spot at all. I don't expect this will stop me. I don't expect this will slow me down. I feel like the only unscathed survivor of a massive plane crash, and I happen to be a medic or a doctor or a nurse, and I look around me at nothing but writhing, broken, near-dead bodies. I want to save everyone there. And I'll work, and I'll work, and I'll work, and I'll work. To have no one to work with is really hard. I don't have time to worry about it. I don't have time to wallow in the misery of it. Not a second a day. But I'm aware of it. A friend asked me earlier today whether the rain was getting me down. No, the rain's irrelevant. But the constant isolation and solitude, really for 8 years now, that's hard. I think the amazing thing is that it isn't stopping me. I think the amazing thing is that it isn't slowing me down. I am not aware of a shred of arrogance or sense of superiority or anything like that that keeps me going. What keeps me going is a sense of the dread of where we're headed, the horror of where we're headed, and the enormous clarity on the direction we need to go. And if I'm the only one that stands that direction and moves that direction, I don't think I'll stop until my heart stops, until my breath stops, until my brain stops. No inclination of stopping. And I don't hold myself accountable for anyone else catching fire, though I totally devote my life to burning so brightly that others, if they can, do.